Well, Darren Purchese is a pastry and dessert chef, but most relevantly, a close friend of Jock's, and he's here with us now to reflect on today's sad news. Darren, I'm astonished you're here, frankly. It must be just about impossible.
It's really hard to believe at this stage. Same as everyone, you know, I woke up this morning and I was really excited to be watching Jock do his thing on MasterChef. I know he loved doing that, and he loved mentoring people, and he seemed to love his life. So it just really is such a shock that I'm sitting here talking about Jock, who was a really good friend of mine. You know, a friend slightly different in terms of, you know, I'm not Jimmy Barnes. We weren't hanging out all the time, cooking up and singing. He was the sort of friend that that I really valued. It was very precious because I could talk to him about anything. We found a real camaraderie. We met on the set of MasterChef a few years ago, and before he was a judge, we were both guest chefs, and quickly we hit it off and realised we had the same friends back in London. We went to the same places after work, and there was quite a small chef community, and we're all part of that, although I didn't know him then. So we really clicked, and he's had some tough times in his life, and I've had a few tough times, and he was always someone that I could call, and any time of day or night he would pick up, and I valued his friendship because he would support me 100%. I know he's done that to lots of other people out there as well.
Darren, I'm so sorry for your loss. Have you heard how his family is going? I mean, it's unimaginable what they're going through right now.
I honestly have no idea. Yeah. But my thoughts go out to Lauren, his wife, who I've met a few times. We're not close. And, of course, his children. He was a devoted family man. He absolutely loved his family. He was so proud of them. And that's why this is such a shock, and I can only imagine what they're going through. So, really, I'm just here to tell you that he was a great friend to me, and he was someone that I could call on any time. And often he would just call me out of the blue or send me a text and just make sure I'm OK. And that could have been at times when things weren't going great for me in business or life, and he kind of seemed to have, like, a prescient communication. He would often reach out, and I think, wow, that's great. And he's one of the only ones, and I'm sure he does that to lots of people. He did lots of kind stuff, lots of thoughtful things, big and small. Whenever a guest chef would be on MasterChef, he loves his coffee. He makes every guest chef or every guest a coffee, and he has to make it perfectly because he's a perfectionist. So you're sitting in hair and makeup, and he's in there whipping up a coffee for absolutely anyone. And he had a wicked sense of humour. Talking about carbonara, I did a carbonara on Instagram Live once, and I thought it was going really well, but, you know, I'm a pastry chef, so I got a call straight after that from Jock, and he said, you know, Rome had been on the phone there demanding an apology. So he had a wicked sense of humour. I can't speak highly enough of the man. I know that all of Australia is in shock, but I know the hospitality industry, the chef community in particular, just cannot believe it because he was such a star. He was an absolutely phenomenal chef, first and foremost, and then, you know, just such a great person.
It's interesting that you speak about how he would call you and check up on you because he was very open about having conversations about mental health, particularly when it comes to blokes, because you guys tend to shut down a bit.
Yeah.
On MasterChef, he was very open as well. Lots of emotion we saw from him. Do you think that's the reason why he was much loved by fans of the show?
For sure. Because, I mean, that's one of the main reasons why we really connected. I felt that I could talk to him about absolutely any subject. And he wasn't... Although he's a big Scottish, he's a masculine guy, I could talk to him about stuff that really mattered. And that's how I remember his friendship. We would often talk about stuff that I wouldn't talk about with a lot of other people. And I opened up to him, he opened up to me. And in the maybe 6 or 7 years that I've known him, he's always been there for me, although I didn't see him every day.
Mm. There's the public perception of Jock, the celebrity chef, the charity work, all this amazing stuff. What's your fondest memory of him?
My fondest memory, he just loves food. He absolutely loves food. I've never known anyone who loves food as much as Jock. He's cooking all the time. He's eating all day on set. I've never seen anyone with such an appetite, but so knowledgeable about food and just really supportive of other chefs and of the industry and of the hospitality industry in particular. I know that he absolutely loved doing the role of MasterChef because he loves passing on his knowledge. Mm. So it's just really infectious, so much charm, so much charisma, and just such a massive shock and a massive loss.
Huge loss.
We're so sorry about your friend.
Yeah, so well said. Thanks so much for joining us in these circumstances. I know it must be really, really hard, but we've gained so much just from being able to speak to you, so thank you.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it.